music aboard. I'm joining LE from BeatBuddy, and we're going to walk you through the history of getting the idea, getting it crowdfunded, and getting it on the market. Thank you, LE, to join me and to help me out with the story behind BeatBuddy.
Thank you. Absolutely my pleasure. So I guess the first thing you want to know is how we came up with the idea. As they say, necessity is the mother of invention. My brother and I were jamming, and we really just wanted one for ourselves. We wanted something like this. And, you know, we asked all our friends, where can we get a drum machine that we can control while we jam? And they're like, I don't know, I'm sure it exists. Go look. And we looked everywhere, and there was nothing like it. The drum machines, they either sounded fake, they had to be used with your hands, so you couldn't be jamming and control it at the same time. They were cumbersome and hard to use, and with thick manuals, and we just wanted one. And so my brother actually had the idea for the format of it. And every time we talk to our musician friends and we're like, do you know where we can get this? And they're like, no, but when you find out, let me know because I want one. Yeah, so we knew that at that point when everyone's like, as soon as you find us, let us know. I've never heard of this, but as soon as you find us, let us know. That's when we knew that we had to create it.
What kind of technical know-how do you need to make a product like this? Or you just donate the idea and find somebody who does it?
Well, we both have an engineering background, so we have a little bit of technical know-how. Honestly, though, if you have an idea for something, I don't think that should limit you. Like, you shouldn't say, I'm not an engineer, I shouldn't be able to create it, because you can always find someone to create it. The first thing that we did was we went online to forums of guitar players and bass players, and we told everyone, we're like, hey, you know, we really want to make this machine. What do you want out of it? And everyone's like, oh, I've been waiting for this for 10 years or 20 years. I've always wanted something like this. You have to have MIDI sync. Oh, it has to sound like this. It can't be quantized. And different people wanted very different things. Oh, yeah, we need a portable. Some people were like, we need it to be so simple to use that I can use it right out of the box. And other people are like, I need it to be so powerful that I can create my own songs on it and everything. And so you have the really basic users, the really advanced users, and they're all asking for different things. And we took all their considerations into account, and I think we eventually came up with a design that was able to be very simple for the very basic user, that if you don't know how to do drum machines at all, you could just take it out and use it without needing any manual, without needing to, you know, 5 minutes of understanding it. At the same time, it has a lot of potential for the very advanced users, that if you want to, you know, create albums with it or create your own material. So we eventually came up with a design that we think satisfied everybody on the internet.
And if you sort of estimate the percentage between the technical aspect, housing, the software aspect, programming the whole thing, and the human interface aspect of being able to operate it, where's the main focus?
Well, I would say the main focus is design. You have to know what it is, what you want it to do, and everything else is you figure out how you accomplish that design. Like, if you come in just with a very technical programming or like the hardware components, but you don't have the musician in mind, it's not going to work. So I would say the most important thing, the thing that is the, you know, that glues it all together, is feel you're a musician. What do you want? What do you want the experience to be? How do you want to feel when you're using it? And I think that's the most important thing. Everything else was just figuring out how can we make it do what we wanted and not cost $1 million.
Talking about money has to be available to live a dream. And you went the very proactive route, put it that way, and put your idea out first and put it to crowdfunding. Back here in Germany, crowdfunding for most people is, if music related, an issue for getting a CD released or something like that, but not to have a musical instrument or product being released. You're ahead of time for us. Can you say some motivation words for others to follow that path and how it worked, basically?
I just want to tell my German friends that you really should look into crowdfunding, because the thing is, if you have an idea and a dream of something you want to create, and then you go to a big corporation and say, this is my idea, they could take your idea, or they could say, okay, give me 60% of it, and I want to make all these changes to it. Crowdfunding is the ultimate way to know that you have a good idea and that you should go to market, because you both get the money you need and prove that your idea is good at the same time. Because if you go to an investor and an investor gives you $1 million and you create an item, then it could be a total flop. The only way crowdfunding actually raises the money is if it's popular. And if it's popular, it's a success. And if it's a success, you raised your money. If you didn't raise your money, you probably shouldn't have raised the money anyway. So we went to crowdfunding. We went to the internet and we said to the internet, we want to make this. We've already had some prototypes. We've already done a bunch of preliminary work. This is our design. This is what it does. Here's a prototype. We demonstrated it. And we said, if you want to see us go to production, pre-order it. And we gave everybody a big discount. We said, if you are willing to put a pre-order in, we'll give it to you at a significant discount. And it was really surprising. We didn't know how many people have been waiting for something like this. We received so many emails of people saying, thank you, I've waited 10 years, I've waited 20 years for something like this. And we received a lot of enthusiastic support. People from all over the world were like, how can I help? How can I make this happen? And we received a lot of good help from people on the internet. They came and they said, let me do some programming for you. Let me raise you money. Let me help you get connected to manufacturers and distributors and everything. So it's really exciting. If you have an idea, with the internet, we can all get together on it and make it happen. And I feel like a lot of the big players, a lot of the big corporations hate crowdfunding for that reason.
Would you have been mentally ready for the internet to say no?
Well, I kind of felt like it would have succeeded, because we didn't just go to the internet like, hey, can you fund this? Before we did that, we already had so many people on the forums. We had so many people on our email list. We had a big community of people who were excited about it before we crowdfunded. So I guess the take-home message is, if you're going to go crowdfunding, the first thing you need to do is make sure you have support and then go, because you don't want to find out that the answer is no. But if the answer was no, I would say, I would have said okay, I know I want it. I hope other people want it. The real reason we wanted to do it is because we wanted an item like this.
So the next step then was to get and have the product ready, and now come to Music Messe, where all the big dogs stroll around as well. Be among them with an idea that started for yourself and that was crowdfunded to production. Congratulations to that.
Thank you. It's really exciting to be at Music Messe. I just remember, I go back to 3 years ago when we were just jamming and being like, wouldn't it be cool if we had this item? Yeah, we need that. And now we're at Music Messe and everyone's coming and putting in orders, and thousands and thousands of people are now using the product in their pedal boards, and that's just so amazing to see.
As we said, stay tuned. Here's the encore. We'll just talk a bit about manufacturing. And I just learned that if you're a startup guy, you just don't go to China to have your product made there. Basically, you move to China to be on the pulse and find out how it works. So where have you been before BeatBuddy existed?
Before BeatBuddy, we're from Miami. And then after crowdfunding and we raised all the money to go make it, then we had to make it. And so we're, you know, we're just some musicians in Miami, and you know, and we're like, okay, we have to make this product now. And so we had to move to China to find our manufacturer. And if you're not there at the factory, it's not going to be made right. You have to be there every step of the way to make sure it's right. And so we had to move to China. We had to live in China. We had to be at the factory all the time. And the whole time it's like, it's crazy. Just like a little bit ago, we had an idea of something we wanted, and now we're living in China, you know, where they don't have milk and they don't have cheese. And I love milk and cheese. And so it's, and so, you know, in a completely different world, there to make it happen. And so you have to go all the way. It's like, if you have an idea that you want to be in the, like, do you have a product you want to create, you want to bring it to the music industry, sometimes you have to go on a long journey to get there. You know, we had to go on the internet to get all the ideas of the design. Then we had to go to crowdfunds and get all the money. Then we had to move to China and, like, live in the factory, essentially. Then come back and now go to Germany, which is my first time in Germany, and to go meet all the people to get it in stores. So, man, when you have an idea, you have to go all over the world and just go on this long, long journey to get it into people's pedal boards. But it's really exciting, and I've loved every step of the way.
So basically, we can close it up with that general don't try at home, because a good idea will drag you out of the door through crowdfunding into China and then back to Germany. Thank you.
Is the Pink Buddy, it's a drum machine and a pedal where you can stop it, you can start it, you can stop it, go dodge it, you can start it again, you can hit the accent or you can bring it into the pedal.
Gonna have more ideas.
We have a lot of ideas. Once we realized it was possible to make an idea come true, and other people are excited about things that you're excited about, we can't stop now. We have a lot of ideas that we're getting ready to make now.
In this case, I don't say goodbye. I say stay tuned. Stay tuned.